welcome back to Sports Buzz. You know, we just had a great MLB talk, but we're going to head back on over to the NCAA. And we have a live looking at our affiliate podcast show, CC Show, with Ryan and PJ. Guys, let's bring back the talk about NCAA.
Thank you very much, guys, for sending up to PJ and I for the CC Sports Show. We're going to keep the men's basketball March Madness trend going a little bit, talk about our Final Four predictions. PJ, out of the Final Four teams left, who do you think move on to the championship, and why do you think?
You know, this tournament's been all over the place this year, and I've loved every bit of it, all these upsets and everything. But for the first game between Loyola Chicago and Michigan, I'm going to have to pick Michigan. I think they're just a more well-rounded team. They're playing great basketball. They've been hot of late, and they've been crushing teams. And I think the Sister Jean luck is going to come to an end, unfortunately. Loyola Chicago, don't knock anything. You guys have done great and made a name for yourself. I haven't even heard of the school before this tournament, so tough stuff to them. But I do think their run's going to come to an end. As for the 8:49 game on Saturday between, you know, Kansas and Villanova, the most talked about game thus far this week, I'm gonna have to side with Villanova on this one. I've been a huge fan of Kansas all year, but I just think Jalen Brunson has the guys playing well. You know, they're blowing teams out in the tournament, and I just think with all the players that they have, and this being a Kansas team that is not as skilled as past, I think Villanova takes on Michigan in the finals on Monday night.
Interesting choices. Not really too surprising, I guess, for some people. For the Michigan-Chicago game, going to have to side with you on that one. I have Michigan winning that. Despite Chicago shooting 40% from three as a team and really chipping in altogether, shooting well from beyond the arc, I think that's where they've gotten a lot of their success in the tournament this year. I think those guys do a great job of opening up the floor for those shooters, but I think they've relied too heavily on the good fortune that's hit them in the tournament and winning on these buzzer beaters, these tough shots.
Plus, Michigan plays great defense.
Yeah, I was just about to say that. Michigan, with their great defense, they contested up to 90% of the Florida State shots last game, according to ESPN stats, and they only held Florida State to shooting, I think, 31% or so shooting from the floor. So I think this modern defense is going to be a little bit too much for the Loyola Chicago Ramblers. And I think, unfortunately, their Cinderella story is going to come up short here, but it's definitely has been a great story, and it's been fun to watch. As much as I would like to see them win, it's a cool story. I just don't see it happening. Talk about the weaknesses that Loyola Chicago has and just relying too much on kind of, I guess, yeah, call it luck or the good fortune that they've been blessed with so far. But I think the only really downside of Michigan's game coming into this Final Four matchup is they've been pretty inconsistent offensively so far in this tournament. Obviously coming off a big win, there's strong potential that they can kill it on offense and score a bunch of points. So if they come offensively, the defense is going to be there, and I think it's going to be too much for Loyola Chicago. And then moving on, the Villanova Kansas game. That's obviously the toughest Final Four matchup, I think, for a lot of people to pick. Being a Duke fan and watching Kansas win that game and watching how Newman was playing and how he dropped 32 against us, and he's shooting 54% from three since the Big 12 tournament. He's been on fire from beyond the arc. I think that's going to continue. And then the only real downside I see to Kansas' game is that as a Duke days, foul trouble is really going to, I think, come into effect. He hasn't played more than 25 minutes in any tournament game so far this tournament. He's also a 41% free throw shooter, so he's going to become a liability late in the game if he's still in there.
He has been falling out of a lot of games.
And I think that's going to be a big impact. I think it's going to be a very close game, so free throws are going to be a major key for that game. And for Villanova, they've been, you know, an offensive juggernaut all season as well as in the tournament. I think they'll have a great team. But the only really negative I see is that, as for a couple of years ago when they won their national title, they really were able to just outrun teams and outshoot teams. And I think the teams remaining, especially Kansas, can really match up well with them. They have very similar play styles, and I think that's Nova's advantage in that category is going to kind of be halted. It's been a great game either way, no doubt about that. But I do see Kansas coming out on top slightly, with Norman leading the way, shooting threes, lights out like he did against Duke.
Now that the picks are in, would you say that the Kansas-Villanova game is essentially the national championship game?
I think people can definitely say that those are the two best teams remaining. And I think the team comes out on top on that side of the bracket, moves on to the championship, will end up being the champion of this year's March Madness in 2018. It has been a very mad March. I'm sure everybody can agree with their brackets have been put out the window after, you know, even the first
after the first round,
the second round for sure. So the picks are in. I think it's Michigan and Michigan for PJ. Myself, it's going to be Kansas and Michigan in the championship game. We'll see how the games go on this weekend.
Should be a fun final.
Final four. And back to you guys. Thank you very much.
Well, thanks, Ryan and PJ. We appreciate your input on the NCAA tournament. But we're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, we're going to head into the NBA.